It's marfu. If I say dan, it's mansu. If I say din, it's majru. If I say dun, it's marfu. If I say dan, it's mansu. If I say din, it's majroor. So, dun dun dan dan din din, 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 dun dun dan dan din din. One more time. If I say dun, it's marfu. If I say dan, it's mansub. If I say din, it's majrur. So, dun dun dan dan din din, dun dun dan dan din din, dun dun dan dan din din, dun dun dan dan. Din din. I hope you will remember it. All these things. And if you don't remember, what will you do then? You will be singing. What will you be singing? Hawa mein udta jaye mera fiel aur mera file. Ho ji. All these will fly over you. Huh? The file will fly, the fiel will fly. Okay, ready? हवा में उड़ता जाए मेरा फ़ैल और मेरा फ़ाइल हो जी इधर उधर लहराए मेरा मुदाफ़ मुदाफ़िले ही इधर उधर लहराए मेरा मुदाफ़ और मुदाफ़िले ही Oji, Oji. This you will be singing then. But we don't want you to sing this, brother. Inshallah. Jazakumullahu khair. Ameen wa salatu wa salamu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa azwajihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd fa'audhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Rabbish rahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa ahlu luktatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbi zidni ilman ajma'in inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase in all of us knowledge. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Harf jar? MashaAllah. Loudly. Harf jar? Ism majroor. So that will inshallah be part of our memory inshallah. Brothers and sisters, we do our drill. Ready? All of us together. Huwa, huma, hum. Hiya, huma, hunna, anta, antuma, antun, anti, antuma, antunna, ana, nahnu. Huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, hunna, anta, antuma, antum, anti, antuma, antunna, ana, nahnu. Last time. Huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, hunna, anta, antuma, antum, anti, antuma, antunna, ana, nahnu. MashaAllah. Now, brother, we come to Zahaba. We'll try to conjugate in the sequence of pronouns. Ready? Zahaba, Zahaba, Zahabu, Zahabat, Zahabata, Zahabna, Zahabta, Zahabtuma, Zahabtum, Zahabti, Zahabtuma, Zahabtunna, Zahabtu, Zahabna. MashaAllah. When you do in sequence, every verb will become easy. Then, now we have to think quickly when we come across a noun. Then we have to figure out what form of verb is appropriate for it. For example, huwa, Zahaba. Hiya, Zahabat, fine. Muhammadun, Zahaba. Aminatu, Zahabat. At-tullabu, Zahabu. Hum, Zahabu. Al-awladu, Zahabu. Inshallah. At-talibatu, remember, batu. At-talibatu, Zahabna. An-nisa'u, Zahabna. Okay, al-ummuhatu zahabna. Al-abu zahaba. Al-ummu zahaba. Okay, ana zahabtu. Ana zahabtu. Nahnu zahabna. Anta zahabta. Anti zahabti. Zahabti. Anti zahabti. Okay, and antuma zahabtuma. Antuma zahabtuma. Antum, zahabtum. Antunna, zahabtunna. Got the idea? Ana, zahabtu. Ana, zahabtu. And then we'll be asking you questions and you'll be answering, you know. Hal zahabta ila suq al-yom? What is the translation? Did you go to the market today? Hal zahabta ila suq al-yom? Naam, zahabtu. هل ذهبتي إلى المسجد اليوم؟ نعم ذهبت. See, your answer is I went. So you will say ذهبت. Are you with me? هل ذهبت إلى السوق اليوم يا حسن؟ ذهبت. هل ذهبتي إلى المسجد اليوم يا فايرة؟ نعم ذهبت. You follow? That's the way we'll practice, inshallah. See, later on, we should be very comfortable with using of the verb form to the proper subject, inshallah. Okay, next one, brother. Kharaja. Kharaja, 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 kharaju, kharajat, kharajata, harajna, harashta, harashtuma, harashtum, harashti, harashtuma, harashtunna, harashtu, harajna. Ana, harashtu. Nahnu, harajna. Huwa, haraja. Muhammadun, haraja. Aliyun, haraja. At-tullabu, haraju. Al-awladu, haraju. Al-mudarrisuna, haraju. Al-mudarris, haraja. According to the pronoun, or noun, we will use, according to the, you know, noun, we will use the proper word form. Okay, brothers and sisters? Nahnu, kharajna. Antum, kharajtu. Ana, kharajtu. Anta, kharajta. Anti, kharajti. Only in third person we will be using at-talib, at-tullab, al-mudarris, al-mudarrisuna, al-awlad, al-waladu. Only in third person. Otherwise, in rest of the thing, it will be anta, anti, antuma, ana, nahnu. Inshallah. Come to jalasa, brother. Jalasa, jalasa, jalasu, jalasat, jalasata, jalasna, jalasta, jalastuma, jalastum, jalasti, jalastuma, jalastunna, jalastu, jalasna. Al-waladu, jalasa. Al-bintu, jalasa. Masha'Allah. Al-awladu, jalasu. At-tullabu, jalasu. Al-mudarrisuna, jalasu. Al-mudarrisu, jalasa. Al-mudarrisatu, jalasat. Al-mudarrisatu, jalasat. Got the idea? Al-mudarrisatu, jalasat. Al-mudarrisatu, jalasna. If you make mistake, it's normal. Don't worry. But later on, brothers and sisters, you are going to get strong and perfect. You won't make mistakes, inshallah. So do not get nervous or gabrified if you make a mistake. It's okay. We are going to learn from our mistakes. Okay, brothers and sisters? Ana jalastu. Nahnu jalasna. Anta jalasta. Anti jalasti. Okay, well. Again, one more time. At-talibu jalasa. At-tullabu jalasa. Al-mudarrisuna jalasu. Al-mudarrisuna jalasu. Al-mudarrisu jalasa. Al-mudarrisatu jalasat. Al-mudarrisatu jalasna. Because these plurals are still new to us, it takes a little time, but inshallah, it will work out fine. Raja'a. And we are going to talk about all these things in a sentence. In a day or two, I'll be asking you a sentence and you'll be replying, inshallah. Raja'a, to return. Raja'a, raja'a, raja'u, raja'at, raja'ata, raja'ana, raja'ata, raja'atuma, raja'atum, raja'ati, raja'atuma, raja'atunna, raja'atu, raja'ana. Fine, brother? Hamidun, raja'a. Khadijatu, raja'at. Fatimatu, raja'at. Ali, raja'a. At-tullabu, raja'u. At-talibatu, raja'na. Al-mudarrisuna, raja'u. Al-mudarrisu, raja'a. Al-mudarrisatu, raja'at. Al-mudarrisatu, raja'na. Anta, anti, ana, nahnu, antum. Inshallah. It's, but this is all fun. What we are doing? We are playing game now. Alhamdulillah. Now we come to kataba. Kataba, kataba, katahu, katabat, katabata, katabna, katapta, kataptuma, kataptum, katapti, kataptuma, kataptunna, kataptu, katabna. Ana, kataptu. Anta, katapta. Anti, katapti. Nahnu, katabna. Muhammadun, kataba. Aminatu, katabat. Al-mudarrisu, kataba. Al-mudarrisuna, katabu. Al-mudarrisatu, katabat. Al-mudarrisatu, katabna. Antum, kataptum. Nahnu, katabna. Alhamdulillah, it's getting there. Fahima, he understood. Huh? Brothers and sisters, as I said to you, it is very important to understand that the meaning of Fahima is he understood. But when you go to dictionary, it will say to understand. So that should not put you off. Because the root form of the verb, brothers and sisters, there are four things which are extremely, you know, important to remember. The base form of the verb. I sometimes say base form, sometimes I say root form. Huh? Okay? Which means the first form of the verb, which is huwa. All the verbs will start with a huwa. Okay? He did something. Okay? Not she, not they, but he. So in other words, the base form of the verb is past tense. Are you with me? Always past tense. And then it is third person. Are you with me? The base form is past tense and then it is third person. Maybe I should write it down. Did I explain you before?
Yes, you did.
But maybe I'll write it down. You can also write down. Huh? Four things are in the base or the root form. Huh? Brother, I'll write base form or the root form. Brother. Number one, it is always past tense. Number two, it is always third person. Number three, it is always singular. And what is the fourth thing, brothers and sisters? It is always masculine.
The sequence doesn't matter,
right? No. Not really. Just understanding. Understand, you can change the sequence. Okay. It really doesn't matter. This is always the root form of the Arabic word. All the Arabic word. Whether it is the base is three letters, and then we will learn later on to make more meanings of the verbs, we add something to it. Okay? And even if it is a six-letter verb, it will still be past tense, third person, singular, and masculine. Okay? Okay. For example, I give you, this is a verb which comes in the Quran, and it is not normal, but I'll say to you. We are going to learn this in book 3. What is the verb, brother? Istafa. What is the meaning of it? It is past tense, third person, masculine and singular. Istafa, if you look into the dictionary, it will say to choose. What will say, dictionary will say? To choose. But actually, he chose. He chose. Okay? So, this is how it works, brothers and sisters. Now, this is, I did not write a three-letter word, but I wrote a different kind of word. But just to emphasize the meaning. So, when you say Fahima, he understood. Afiza, he memorized. Got the idea? Always those four things will be there in the basement. Okay, brothers and sisters, now we say Fahima quickly. Fahima, Fahima, Fahimu, Fahimat, Fahimata, Fahimna, Fahimta, Fahimtuma, Fahimtum, Fahimti, Fahimtuma, Fahimtunna, Fahimtu, Fahimna. Are you with me, brother? Muhammadun, Fahimna. Aminatu, Fahimat. Al-Auladu, Fahimu. At-Tullabu, Fahimat. At-Talibatu, Fahimat. At-Talibatu, At-Talibatu, Fahimna. Ana, Nahnu, Fahimna. Anta, Fahimta. Anti, Fahimti. Antum, Fahimtum. Inshallah. Now we do the last one. Hafiza. Hafiza, Hafiza, Hafizu, Hafizat, Hafizata, Hafizna, Hafista, Hafistuma, Hafistum, Hafisti, Hafistuma, Hafistunna, Hafizu, Hafizna. Okay, brother? Hamidun, Hafiza. Zainabu, Hafizat. At-Tullabu, Hafizu. At-Talibatu, Talibatu, Hafizna. An-Nisa'u, Hafizna. Anta, Anti, Nahnu, Hafizna. Antum, Hafistu. Ana, Hafistu. Got the idea? Inshallah. We stop here. Right? Inshallah. Now we go to the section, brothers and sisters. And we are learning here now, Ha'ulai. And as you know, Ha'ulai is also Ismu Ishara. Ismu Ishara is a pronoun. All pronouns are definite. Huh? Okay, brothers and sisters. If a noun comes after Ismu Ishara, and if it is definite, then it becomes the badal. Inshallah, we'll remember that. Man ha'ulail fatayatu ya Maryam. Who are these young ladies, O Maryam? Okay. So, brother, question marks we don't analyze. But just briefly, ha'ulai is ismu ishara. And what will be al-fatayatu? Badal. Inshallah. Hunna. هن زميلاتي. What is هن brother? مبتدا. And where is our خبر? زميلاتو. See, زميلاتي, how many words are there? Two words. مضاف, مضاف إليه. صحيح. So our خبر is going to be زميلاتو. وهو مضاف. And يا متكلم مضاف إليه. Very good, brother. أخواتهن are the sisters. نعم هن أخواتن. So, what is Hunna, brother? Hunna is your Mubtada. Akhwatun is your Khabar. Man Abu Hunna. Watch at the spelling of Abu. Waw has come. Why? Because it became Mudaf. There are five nouns in Arabic language. They have their own spelling rules. Their spelling rules become very different when they come as a mudaf. We are learning here Abu and Akhu. So when Abu and Akhu become mudaf, and if they are marfu, they get waw. Are you with me? They get waw. Okay? So Abu Hunna is with waw. Abu is with waw. So Abu Hunna is mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Okay. Man Abu Hunna. Who is their father? What is the answer? Abu Hunna. Abu Hunna. Mudaf mudaf ilayhi. But first and foremost, what is Abu? Mubtada. Wahuwa mudaf. And then mudaf ilayhi. Fine. Abu Hunna ash-shaykhu. Their father is the sheikh. Fine. Sheikh is khabar. Sometimes the khabar can be definite. And in this case, it is definite. Normally, it is most of the time indefinite. Now comes Bilalun. Is Bilalun definite or indefinite?
Definite.
Why? Because it is a proper noun. It is definite because it's a proper noun. So what do you call now Bilalun?
Badal.
So Badal can come in this form also. It will be very easy to recognize, inshallah. You will have no difficulty, inshallah. Ummuhunna, again, ummuhunna, how many words?
Two.
What are they? Mudaf mudafili. So what will you call the first word? Ummu mubtada. Wa huwa mudaf. And then mudafili. This is the way we will approach our analysis, you know. Ustazati. How many words are there?
Two.
What is the combination? Mudaf mudafili. If I ask you what kind of a murakkab is, what kind of a combination is, we will say mudaf mudaf ilayhi, or we will say nat manut, or you will say jar majrur. Or you will say zarf and mudaf ilayhi. These are the combination we will try to figure out. And that will facilitate our understanding and our analysis. So where is the khabar? Ustazatu. Tu. Because ti only became of the ya mutakallam. Khabar is always marfu. So it is ustazatu. Okay. Remember, brother, if the khabar is one word, it is always marfu. Marfu. Okay. So if you say ustaza is one word, ustaza, then it is ustazatu. Aina baitu hunna. Baituhunna, how many words? What is the combination? Mudaf mudafili. Where is their home? What is the answer? Baituhunna. Again, two words. So what is the first word? Baitu? Mubtada. But before Mubtada, I will say Mubtada, and then I will say. So Baituhunna, brothers and sisters, there are two words. The first word, Baitu, is our Mubtada, wa huwa mudaf. And then mudaf ilayhi. Got the idea, inshallah. Qareebun khabar. Min al madrasati jar majrur. Inshallah. Okay, brother. Now, next exercise, brothers and sisters, is hawwil mubtada. Change the mubtada into jama. Okay? So, what is mubtada? Hadihi. Now, change it into jama. It will be haulai. Then the khabar has to be also in jama. Okay. We have an example. So what will be the number one? Hadihi talibatun. Haulai talibatun. What is talibatun? Jama monas salim. Sound feminine plural. Again I say. Sound feminine plural. هذه مدرسة. What will you say? هؤلاء مدرساتن. Remember, still marfu. Unless something comes in front of it, it will remain marfu. Okay. هذه طبيبة. هؤلاء طبيبات. مبتدا خبر. هذه مسلمة. هؤلاء Muslimatun. Very good. Hadhi zawjatun. Haulai zawjatun. Okay. Hadhi ukhtun. Haulai akhawatun. Okay. Hadhi fatatun. Haulai fatayatun. Okay. Hadhi jadidatun. Haulai jududun. Jududun. Haulai jududun. Are you with me? Haulai jududun. Now remember, brother, jududun is applicable in both masculine form and feminine form. So we have to just remember, brother. Hadhihi kabiratun, haulai kibarun. Again, the same for masculine and same for feminine. All of the rest. Hadhihi sagiratun. Haulai sigarun. Hadhi tawilatun. Haulai tibarun. MashaAllah. Okay. Ikra waktub. Read and write. I hope you have done it in the weekend. If not, then please write it, okay? Haulai ikhwati. What is haulai? Mubtada. How many words are there in ikhwati?
Two.
What is the combination? Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. So ikhwatu is our khabar, wa huwa mudaf, and then mudaf ilayhi. Okay. Wa haulai akhwati. These are my brothers, and these are my sisters. Okay. Man haulai al-fatayatu. Who are these young ladies? Haulai banatul mudarrisati. Haulai banatul mudarrisati. Fine, brothers and sisters. So, banatul mudarrisati, what is this? Mudaf mudafili. Fine. So, haulai is our mubtada and our khabar is banatul only. Very good. Next one, interesting. Haulai fatayatu. Haulai mubtada. What is fatayatu?
Badal.
Badal. See, you can easily see that it is badal. It's coming after ismu shara and it is definite now. Zamilati mudaf mudafilay. So, zamilatu is your khabar. Abuhunna. What kind of combination is this? Mudaf. So what will be Abu? Mubtada. Wahua mudaf. And then Hunna mudafile. Tabibun is your khabar. Wa ummuhunna, waw is ataf. Ummuhunna same. Mudaf mudafile. Inshallah it should make a understanding very clear now. Once we understand mudaf mudafile. Ummuhunna, ummu is your mubtada. Mudaf and hunna mudaf ilay mudarrisatun. Fine, brother. Aina talibatul jududu. Where are the new students? Now comes our jumla failure. What is it now? The jumla starts with a verb. Zahabna ilal maktabati. So what is zahabna? Fail. Where is the file?
Na.
You will always, 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 when you see a fi'l, we got to have a file. And when the file is attached, as it is in this case, nunu niswa is your file. And you will always, always analyze. Break it apart for our understanding. Okay, I will do it, brother. So when you see something like this, you can say to yourself, where is the fi'l? Remember, when the hunna comes, the lam kalima gets a sukoon. Where did the sukoon go to? Lam kalima. Remember, third radical, always sukoon. Okay, so where is the fi'l? This is the way you will always describe. If I say zahabta, so zahab will become your fi'l and ta will become your file. If I say zahabtu, then sahab is your fi'l and tu is your file. If I say zahabna, zahab is your fi'l and na is your file. Always, always we will separate them. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Any verb that comes. In the case of huwa and hiya, file can be mustatir or it can be present in the jumla. Okay. What is the next one, brother? Aina banatuki ya ammati. Where are your daughters, O my aunt? Okay. Hunna fil matbakhi. They are in the kitchen. So brother, very simple sentence. Hunna mubtada. Where is your khabar? Brother and sisters, where is your khabar? Jar majur, shibu jumla, khabar. Okay. Aha ulai mumarridatu muslimatun. Are these nurses Muslims? Naam. Yes. هؤلاء طبيبات. These are doctors. مبتدا خبر. أزواجهن. What kind of a combination is this? مضاف مضاف إليه. Okay. مدرسون. What is مدرسون sisters? خبر. خبر. Fine, brothers and sisters. من هذه المرأة؟ هذه المرأة. What kind of a combination is this, Sister Faiza? هذه المرأة. What kind of a combination is this? هذه المرأة. هذه المرأة. هذه اسم إشارة. And المرأة is بدل. So, not all the time مضاف مضاف إليه. You got to watch. If it is ismu ishara, you got to be careful. With ismu ishara, the noun that is definite is badal. Okay? Fine, brother. Hiya zawjatut tabibil jadidi. Are you with me? Hiya zawjatu tabibi. So where is our khabar? Zawjatu. Wahuwa mudaf. And tabibi? مضاف إليه. And then Sister Fatima, what is Al-Jadidi? No, it has come At-Tabibi Al-Jadidi. At-Tabibi Al-Jadidi. Nahat, mashallah. Got to watch. See, the signs are there for us to figure out that it is now Nahat. Okay. And remember, Nahat follows the Manut. Okay, so here At-Tabibi is Majroor, so the Naat is also Majroor, Al-Jadidi. Fine, brother. Abanatuka fil madrasati thanawiyati, Ya Osama, are your daughters in the secondary school, Osama? What is the answer? Ba'duhunna. Okay. But Hassan, what is ba'duhunna?
Some of them.
Some of them, I know that. Oh. What kind of a combination is that? There are two nouns. So what kind of a combination is that? Ba'duhunna. When the pronoun joins a noun, we get mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Got the idea? So what is it, brother? Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Remember this, brother, when the pronoun will join the noun, the result is mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. And when the pronoun joins the preposition, jar majrur. And when the pronoun joins zarf, it is zarf and mudaf ilayhi. All these things should register well in our mind. And there is a fourth thing coming in the later on in book 2. We'll study that, inshallah. So, ba'duhunna fil madrasati. So, where is our mubtada, brother? Brother Abdul Samad, where is our mubtada?
Ba'du.
Ba'du only, mashallah. Wahuwa? And then mudafila, mashallah. And fil madrasati jar majrur shibu jumla khabar. And Abdul Samad, what is the thanawiyati? Naat. Very good. Wa ba'duhunna, same fil madrasati mutawassitati. And some of them are in the middle school. Well, now the question is, we are asking layla. So you see, no vowel signs. So what will be a la ki? A la ki banatun ya layla? Do you have daughters, ya Layla? Naam. Li banatun kibarun. Li banatun kibarun. So brother, what is li here? How many words are there?
Two.
What kind of a combination is this? Charun wa majrurun. Char wa majrurun. Okay. And then, brother, banatun. What will you say to the banatun? Mubtada. And what is kibarun? Naat. Alhamdulillah. Very good. Wahunna, and they are Mubtada, طالبات خبر بالجامعه جار مجرور very good من هؤلاء النساء الطوال okay who are these tall ladies هن طبيبات من امريكا هن they are doctors from USA طبيبات is your خبر هن is your مبتدا الطبيبات now see look at this sentence carefully الطبيبات what shall I call this sentence جملة اسمية fine I'll call this جملة اسمية where is the خبر جملة فعلية is your خبر Brother Salman الطبيبات the doctors give me the news about the doctor what is the news they went out from the hospital so the khabar is kharajna min al mustashfa okay so what kind of sentence is this kharajna there is a verb here so this is now verbal sentence are you with me this is now your verbal sentence so when it is verb we need our verb and file so where is our verb kharaj 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 is your actual verb you can see fa kalima in kalima lam kalima you can see first radical second radical third radical and what extra do you see the file what do you see extra is your file
when you say the verb you don't go back to the original form and I say kharaj is your verb you ask where is the file
Fear.
Do you not say Karaja?
No. You know why? Here is something that we must understand. And this is what I go back again. See, when you start your conjugation, okay, you start with Hua, Huma, Hum, Hiya, Huma. In those five forms, the verb is Karaja, then again Karaja, And then in home it becomes kharaju with dhamma. And then here again kharaja. And again huma kharaja. That is your verb. Okay? When you say kharaja, alif is your file. Where is the verb? Kharaja. But you know when we come to hunna, brother Abdul Samad, you forgot your agreement with them? No. What is our agreement? Hunna says, when I come and everybody who will follow me, they will get a sukoon. So the verb changed from kharaja to kharaj.
Kharaj.
No.
Here, in the form of here.
No, you will just say kharaj. See, if I say kharajta, where is the verb? Kharaj. Now, why? There are reasons. And I did explain you, but if you forgot, don't worry. Because it is too early in this study to go in that much detail. But when we will go in book 2, and when we will learn naqis verbs, then these things will become very prominent. And we have to understand and specify. Okay. So here is the rule, in short. If the mutaharrik pronouns join the verb as a file, Are you with me?
Yes.
Then the lam kalma will have a sukun. The verb undergoes a change. That's all. That is the reason. Are you with me? Now, why does it get sukun? Why? It is because the mutaharik pronouns come. Okay. And if there are sakin pronouns, as in kharaju or kharaja, then they are normal. Kharaja, kharaja and kharaju, they are normal. Just keep that in mind. So if you start analyzing and if you see a pronoun, mutaharik pronoun coming as a file, what is the meaning of mutaharik pronoun? The pronoun which has got a proper vowel sign. The pronoun which comes as a file has a proper vowel sign. And that is why, brother, I would like you to remember this. From Hunna, we get the file Noon. Are you with me? Now what happens after that? Do you see this, brothers and sisters? I find it very amusing. What is that? Tatumatum titumatunna tuna. If you practice, you will memorize it. What is it? Tatumatum, tatumatum titumatunna tuna. I want you to learn to say very fast. Tatumatum titumatunna tuna. Slowly, slowly we'll learn. Now, what is this tatumatum titumatunna tuna? These are the files. But they are pronouns. And they are file. And they are marfu. Still, it is early in our study to go through all these things. I am just introducing them. We will keep talking about them for a long, long time. But by that time, you will become master. So any verb that you do after Hunna, where you will put your Noon as a file, Sahih, brother? Mm-hmm. Take all the verbs. Start from here. Hunna, what will you say? Kharajna. What will you say? Jalasna. And what will you say? Rajana. What will you say? Katabna. Fahimna. Hafizna. Now what did you do? You gave third radical sukun. Did you give sukun to third radical? What is the first radical? In kataba, ka. What is second radical? Ta. And what is third radical? Ba. In Arabic we call it fa kalima, ayin kalima, la. Now these are the foundations. If we understand, then the complex verbs will become very easy for you, inshallah. Keeping in mind those kalimas, when they get a sukoon, okay, or even when they get a kasra, it will all come, inshallah. So, brothers and sisters, after you put Noon there, then that third radical will remain sukoon. And what you are adding, Brother Muhammad, what did you add afterward? Tatumatum titumatunna tuna. Makes the job very easy, brother. After Hunna, these are the files. So you will take the verb and give a sukun to the third radical and then add these files. So that is why you must write. You write and you will become expert, inshallah. It's very easy. And I will be repeating it.